Hello, my name is Connor King, and I'm going to be talking a little bit about the Hollywood 10 and H.U.A.C. for my presentation. Okay, basically it all started back in the 1940s and continued through the 1950s. Hundreds of U.S. entertainment artists lost the right to work in their industry. They lost the opportunity to do what they love, and they lost the ability to provide them for themselves and for their family, all based on their alleged political beliefs, and some were involved with the American Communist Party, which was well within their rights to be involved with that. This was all brought on by the H.U.A.C., which stands for the House Committee of Un-American Activities. And what H.U.A.C. was in charge of, the U.S. House of Representatives created them to investigate subversive activities. Any U.S. Disloyalty to the U.S. government, any communist infiltration in the United States, and that was their initial task, and eventually they turned their sights towards the entertainment industry, as they believed there was a lot of communist, socialist ideology going on in the entertainment industry. So I'm going to show you a little bit about that. Although H.U.A.C.'s job was to investigate potential subversion, conspiracies, and disloyalty, they mainly focused their attention towards people with left-wing political beliefs. The members of H.U.A.C. had a great deal of power with their ability to issue subpoenas and force testimony.
The question is, have you ever been a member of the Communist Party? I'm framing my answer in the only way in which any American citizen can frame his answer.
Then you deny it, but
then you may have been absolutely invaded.
Then you deny it.
I had my way about it. They'd all be sent back to Russia or some other unpleasant place.
In 1947, H.U.A.C. summoned several entertainment professionals to testify. Some entertainers complied while others refused, claiming the hearings were an infringement on their constitutional rights and did not want to implicate themselves or their peers. This group that stood against the H.U.A.C. became known as the Hollywood 10. The Hollywood 10 only further fueled the H.U.A.C., as these publicized hearings led the film industry to produce the Waldorf Statement, which stated the firing of the Hollywood 10 and indicated the desire to eliminate subversives from the entertainment industry, bringing about the Hollywood Blacklist.
Have you ever been a member of the Communist Party? I believe I have the right to be confronted with any evidence which supports this question. I should like to see what you have.
Oh, will you?
Yes.
Well, you will.
The Blacklist tragically impacted the entertainment industry for nearly a decade. If you found yourself on the Blacklist, you were labeled a suspected communist or communist sympathizer. The keyword is suspected because many of the entertainers were persecuted on the basis of questionable and unverifiable information. To be blacklisted meant the death of your career. Many found themselves blacklisted from their industry by being a member of the American Communist Party, by association with believed communists, or by even being involved with liberal causes such as animal rights and humanitarian organizations. The list was not always specific and was sporadically enforced. It was not just movie stars who bared the brunt of the blacklist, but screenwriters, technicians, authors, musicians, and an assortment of other entertainers. The blacklist era was a dark time for Hollywood as well as the rest of the country. The civil liberties of U.S. citizens, such as freedom of speech and political freedom, were being attacked. Careers were ended, families fled the country to avoid imprisonment, and lives were changed forever.
You always heard the one you love, the one you shouldn't hurt. The sweetest rose and crush it till the petals fall. You always break the kindest heart.